Hello, so due to overwhelming demand, I'm going to show you how to put, your own custom background in if you want, a background like that or something. You can go ahead and put in your own custom background like I did and like Shofu did and like other people are doing. This is a how-to video on how to do it. So first, you're going to go ahead and open Desmume with the ROM that you are planning on using. I'm using Pokemon White here. Then you're going to go into Emulation, go to Cheats, List. You're going to go ahead and put in this Action Replay cheat right here. You can pause and check it out for yourself. Feel free right now. And I'm going to go ahead and close it. So if you want to know the code, go ahead and pause. Okay, so after that, you're going to make. After you put it in, you go ahead and click Save. Then you go to X, and then you're going to bring up your Versus Recorder. And press Play. And then you can have it as green, or you can switch the color. Ta-da! Like you have been able to already. Then you're going to check out a video like this right here. And then you're going to go ahead and record AVI. Which I already have something recorded, so I'm not going to go ahead and do it, but make sure you compress it with something. Otherwise, there'll be a massive file size, and then you'll have to, like, render it 500 times to get it to a small file size. Unless you have, like, excellent upload speed. But then, right before you play, you're going to go ahead and hit the select. In my case, it's backspace because it's easy. But you're going to hit the select key on your keyboard, like this. And then when you play, you should get a background like this, which, as you can see, ta-da, green screen background, which means we are able to go ahead and edit stuff because of that. So let me go ahead and open Vegas Pro while that's, doing its thing. And I'm going to go ahead and stop this. And you can go ahead and, like, hard close the ROM. It's not a big deal if you do. So then what you're going to do is you're going to go find your green screen thing. In videos, probably try and make it to a location that you want it to be, and then you're gonna go ahead and open up like a test video right here. And as you can see, normal background thing. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna go like this till you get to a frame about like this, and then keep going for a little bit. Because you want to start getting a frame like that. So right here, you go ahead and go edit. Make sure to click on the video itself. So you go to edit, and of course, stupid thing is going to be like that. So it's going to be stupid. There, black. So you're going to go to edit, split. Now I'm using Vegas Pro 11. And then, yeah, this kind of gives you a start to where you want to use it. And then you go to Google, and in my case, I've just been doing this. Wow, that was the most horrid typing. There. So you're going to go like this, and then you're going to find a background that you really, 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 really enjoy. We're going to go with this one. You're going to save it. And then you can save it as whatever. I'm just going to save it as images 36. And then you're going to go ahead and import that image into Vegas, which is going to allow you to mess with it. And here we go. Darn it, I'm being derpy. Don't pay attention to me being derpy. Okay, there we go. So then, as I said, you're going to bring in the image that you want. And you would think you'd place it here, but nope. Turns out you place it down here, make it a separate audio video track thing, and then put it towards the end of your video. Of course, if you have exit stuff, then you're gonna wanna go ahead and basically not have it. And I'm gonna turn the volume way down, so that we can't even hear it. And so, as you can see, play, can't see anything right now, which is okay because you don't want to see anything right now. And then you're going to go to video effects, and if you're using a different thing, just kind of fool around with it. I'm using Vegas Pro 11 because it's pretty easy via Vegas Pro 11. But if you're using a different thing, the key term you're going to want to choose is this chroma keyer right here. And if you can't see the text full screen, and you should be able to see it, chroma keyer right here, you're going to take this green screen edit and put it onto the clip that has the green screen. And then pretty much all this, you can make it more transparent, less transparent right here. But I go ahead and usually leave it at full, at one, so that you can go ahead and see the background clearly. And then you're going to X. And then when you play, ta-da! You should have a background much like this. The only bad thing is it messes with all the blues in color. And then all the greens, like see the hit point bar being green, it also transparents that. Or if you saw in my last battle, you saw Rayquaza being, kind of transparent with the background. So that is the bad thing about this. And then what you're going to do is you're going to want to render this. I'm not going to because I have an actual example I can show you. So you're going to go ahead and do that. And then it's going to look something along the lines of, hold up, where is it? When you finish it, it's going to look along the lines of this once I find it. Where did I put it? Where did I put it? I think I just, oh, yep, here it is. So it's gonna look along the lines of this. All right, that's all good and dandy. Obviously not the background that I was showing you because, well, that is a test video that you guys should have seen on my channel. And so this is how you green screen and add in backgrounds to your Pokemon videos like me and Shofu and all a bunch of other people are doing and are gonna do. I'm not gonna do it all the time though, 'cause it'd get a little boring not seeing the HP bar, and plus there's other, pretty cool in-game backgrounds you can use as well. But this is a nice tutorial of how to green screen in your background, your own personal backgrounds. For, the versus replayer on your Desmume, in case, you want to track subs or something with cool backgrounds, you now know how. And remember, if you're not using Sony Vegas Pro 11, just make sure the options should say something along the line of chroma keyer or green screen tools, maybe. I'm not really familiar with other video editors as far as green screening goes, but chroma keyer is the technical term, and it's actually really easy. They already went ahead and set up the background in game for you to have a green screen, so that's very nice of them. That's very awesome of them because now we can all put in our own backgrounds. So leave a like if you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Hope this helps those of you out who were asking me like a million and one que Like, all you people who were asking me. There was a lot of people asking me about this, let me tell you. And so, there we go. You guys now know how to add in your own backgrounds. So now you can be cool like the rest of us or something like that. And, yeah. Pretty much it. Hope this really helped you out if you were having trouble. And, just to rephrase a few things, you need Desmume and a ROM, because you can't do this to a normal game cartridge, because you would have to somehow capture the gameplay on your normal game cartridge and then add in like the action replay code on the game cartridge and all that. And that would just be a mess. So Desmume is nice for that reason. If you need the code, just go back to the part where I showed the code and pause it and pick whatever picture you want to use. There's lots of cool pictures on here on Google. Lots of them. And so that's it, guys. Pretty simple, right? Yeah. Let me know in the comments if this helped you out. And I will see you guys later.